Before I conclude this lesson, I want to say a few additional things about the Software Requirement Specification document, or the SRS. And I want to do that because this is a very important document, and some of the projects actually require you to produce one. So why is the requirement specification such an important document? That's because the Software Requirement Specification document is an important, a fundamental way to communicate requirements to others. For example, they represent a common ground between analysts and stakeholders. Note, however, that different projects might require different software requirement specifications, so you need to know your context. For example, the SRS document that you have to create for a small project performed by a few developers can in most cases be a concise and informal one. Conversely, the software requirement specification for a multi-year project involving a number of developers can be a fairly complex and extensive document. So again, you have to be aware of your context and build your software requirement specification accordingly. In order to have a common format for the SRS document, IEEE defined a standard that divides the document in predefined sections. And in the context of this course, we will use a simplified version of the IEEE SRS format that includes three main sections: an introduction, which discusses the purpose, context, and objectives of the project; a user requirements definition, which contains the user requirements; and a system requirements specification, which includes both functional and non-functional requirements. And we provide more information about this format when we discuss the projects. So to conclude the lesson, I want to point out, and in some cases recap, a few important characteristics that requirements should have. First of all, requirements should be simple, not compound. Each requirement should express one specific piece of functionality that the system should provide. Requirements should be testable. We mentioned this before, but I want to stress it because it is a very important point. Untestable requirements, such as the system should be fast, are useless. Requirements should be organized. Related requirements should be grouped. More abstract requirements should contain more detailed requirements. And priorities should be clearly indicated when present. Finally, requirements should be numbered so that they can be traced. For example, number requirements will allow you to trace them to design, implementation, and testing elements and items, which is something that you might have to do for one of the projects and that we will discuss in more detail in a later class.